How does Henry David Thoreau establish the voice of a philosopher in the woods?
At home.
So he says in the first paragraph, he went to the woods because, well, I went to the woods because I wished to live deliberately, to find only the essential facts of life. So it means like he's like been studying life, and like he like has been studying aspects of life before, so he knows like what to do per se when he goes out to the woods, instead of like, no, he goes to the woods to get away from society because he knows he doesn't want to be around society because he wants to live on the simple side of life. So he knows to get away from like the aspects of society because he's been studying the aspects of society. So I don't know if that makes sense, but he like wants to get away from that because he knows like all the facts about it.
Yeah, by studying the aspects of life, you're saying like he was at Harvard, he was at places, he sees what it's like. It's just not for him.
Right.
I kind of want to elaborate on that. So I think, because I don't know, I was like, I didn't understand this, but I think now I do. Is like what you were saying was that like he had already been like in society, he had already like experienced what it was like to be around other people and like that kind of environment. By placing himself into like the woods alone, he was able to appreciate and like really analyze what life is outside of the materialistic things that, you know, like we're so caught up in today. And another thing I wanted to say was a really good way that Thoreau like establishes his philosopher kind of thought in the woods is by using repetition in paragraph 2. He says simplicity, 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 and that that kind of like gives the reader like it just reinstills it in their head like over and over again, so that they like remember like simplicity.
Also, in paragraph 3, he asks a lot of rhetorical questions, and that's also what philosophers do. They ask many questions, and they search for the answer for it. And once they find the answer, they question that answer, and they just keep on like building off their, like, they base their ideas off of the many questions that they have and the answers that they get from those questions.
If I was giving out little chocolates for good comments, I'd be chucking you a couple. Right? All right.
Should we move on to
the next question? Let's break it down by establishing the voice. So now you're talking about techniques like what level diction does he use? How long are his sentences? Are they short ones? Are they long ones?
They're all long.
He keeps talking about how life is like, paragraph 2, he says our life is frittered away by detail. Basically just saying that it's way too much like fluff in there, like it's too complex. And he's just moving to the forest or the woods to be away from all that, and basically to live the simplest life he could live. And he says this in paragraph 1 also. He says, I wanted to live deep, suck out all the marrow of life, to live so sturdily and Spartan-like as to wrap all that was not life, to cut broad swaths, shape clothes, whatever. You know, like basically just drive it down to what life really is.
Very good.
In that example that you used, the suck out the marrow of life to live so sturdily, there's kind of like a sense of irony in that sentence, because when you think sucking out the marrow of life means to like, you know, like deprive yourself of things, but he then uses like to live so sturdily, like kind of saying like, if anything, by taking out all the things that we love, we become like stronger and more like sensible.
Pretty good.
Dakota, you have anything to say?
What does it all sound like? If you base it on hearing the Black Ponder and hearing their comments, what does it sound like this person's purpose is, this writer's purpose? What's he trying to teach?
From what I've heard, because I did not read this, it sounds like he's just trying to escape, however you want to put that, just trying to escape from the materialistic world. I heard someone talking about moving to the woods.
Yeah.
And I would think, my question would be, why the woods? You know, because you can get rid of materialistic things and it not be in the woods. But yeah, I guess it was just more of a, oh, this is forestry and there's nothing out here that is materialistic, so I'm going to run away. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, why the woods? That's actually a good way of answering that question of how he establishes his voice. Why tell us he's going to the woods? Yeah.
The woods question?
Yeah.
Well, I guess he could feel more secluded and surrounded by nature, and most of the industrial noises and city noises he was trying to escape from to seclude himself. And I guess he's trying to provoke his idea upon others by showing how the simple life is more beneficial toward a human being than actually being with society itself, and how society is corrupt.
Pretty good.
Also, from what I heard, what I saw in the page, that his sentences are very long and complex, and a thing that runs in my mind is, why would a very complex man like himself want to be isolated from everything else? Like, I get the point of writing to get other people to know, but I don't see someone as this complex going to isolate themselves, not being able to share their knowledge of anything for that matter.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
Okay, so, basically, I think that he thinks that we, like the people, run on materialistic things instead of materialistic things running on the people. So he moves into the woods because he feels like society is a slave to materialism instead of really controlling that. So yeah. Oh, my bad.
Didn't even reach that. Okay, so I think that he's such an intellectual person, and because he's so intellectual, he's already lived his entire life around society, and since he's so intellectual, he really just wants to see what else there is to do in life, because the world isn't just cities and people around you. Because if he experiences life in the woods and living there, surrounded by nature and not by materialism or people or anything to distract him from the actual beauty of Earth, he could find a new, how do I say, new realization, maybe, that there's more. And I feel like we all know that there's more to life than just materialism, but he just kind of wanted to experience it for himself because he knew that there would be something more and he could experience it.
Very good. All right. You want to shift to the second question?
All right. Let me ask you that.
Yeah.
What rhetorical techniques does Henry David Thoreau use to establish his position in Where I Lived and What I Lived For?
And what we have to figure out is, what is his position? What is he saying about life? What should we be doing about life?
We should stop being so focused on materialism and materialistic things. We need to appreciate the simple things in life instead of bowing down to iPhones or expensive clothing or, stuff like that. So if we just focus on the natural simple things, family, friends, realizing that you're blessed with such simple things that keep you alive every day, that there's more to life than just those materialistic things.
Pretty good. I'll give you chocolate for that one too.
also, his position was kind.
kind of like, he kind of wanted to explore like what life was to him and how he kind of wanted to like find himself kind of in the woods, as well as not dwelling on materialistic things. He kind of wanted to find for himself like who he was, what he wanted to live for. Because he says in like the first paragraph, he said like he wished to live deliberately, and when it, and when I came to die, I discovered like, and then when he came to die, I discovered that he had not lived. Like, he doesn't want to live like knowing that he didn't explore his own life because he was stuck on like those material things. He wanted to explore life for himself and see what he wanted to believe.
Basically, using the same thing like Poe that Makwana used, he's saying that with materialism, you're not really living, and when you like only focus on what you really need in life is when you'll really find the true meaning of life and live like how life was meant to be lived, not enslaved by materialism.
Okay, last comment.
So to answer like what rhetorical techniques he uses, or one of them would be like rhetorical questions, and that makes us question kind of like what around us, like saying if we do not get out sleepers and forge rails and devote days and nights to the work, but go to tinkering upon our lives to improve them, who will build railroads? And if railroads are not built, how shall we get to heaven in season? And he just kind of like builds off his previous questions, making us question like life around us. So like by using those rhetorical questions, he like kind of proves his point by saying that society is kind of like controlling of us and like that.
Very good. Give them a hand.